أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. We continue on looking at some beautiful traditions, hadith, on the importance of the Quran within our lives to reconnect to the Thaqalain, to the Prophet, his family, and the noble Quran, the two inseparable commodities, if you will, from Allah, the ones who will guide us to felicity in this world and the next. And today we want to reflect on a tradition from the sixth Imam, the sixth successor of the Prophet, Imam Ja'far ibn Muhammad al-Sadiq, may God's peace and blessings be upon him, in which he again stresses on the importance of reading, protect, safeguard the Quran, but acts upon the Quran. And he shows us the reward of this individual. Let us look at the hadith and then come back to reflect on these words of the sixth Imam, where he states, "One who protects the Quran and acts upon it as well will be with a noble, devoted angels on the Day of Judgment." Previously in a tradition, we talked about those who memorize the Quran to be at the level just below that of the prophets and the messengers. Here the sixth Imam shows us another level that we could attain, where we would be at the level of the close angels who are in close proximity to Allah by protecting the Quran, by recitation, by memorization, but not to end it there, as he says, to act upon the content. It's easy to read the Quran, it's easy to memorize the verses, but the true beauty comes when we actually apply those verses to our life. So it's easy to read in Surah Hujurat, chapter 49, that Allah created us, that God created you and I from a male and a female, and then spread us into different nations, different colors, different languages. It's easy to read this kind of a verse, but how easy is it to implement, to show that there is no racial discrimination within Islam, to allow a man who may come to marry our daughter, who comes from a different culture, who comes from a different nationality, whose skin tone is different than mine, whose language is different than mine. How easy is it for me to act upon the Quran when Allah says that humanity is one community, just colors being incidental characteristics? It's easy for me to read in the Quran to give 20% of my net savings at the end of my fiscal year to the needy, to certain individuals whom God has delineated within the Quran. But come that day, how easy is it for me to go to my bank account to see the $20,000 in savings and to take $4,000 out and put it aside for those who are deserving of this money? How easy is that? These are challenges, but this is what the sixth Imam is showing us, that it's not enough to just read the Quran, to be a protector of the Quran, to be at the level of the angels. No, we have to act upon the Quran. And not just acting and praying and fasting and all of these acts, but rather go to a level deeper than that. And if we can get to that deeper level of implementing the Quran within our lives, then we'll see the day, the dawn of a society built on the Quran, where there will be economic, social, political justice for all. There will be no oppression, there will be no discrimination, there will be no anything bad that we see in the world today. All of that will be eradicated and eliminated. But that will only come when each and every one of us reads, understands, and implements the Quran within our day-to-day lives. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.